This is Dennis Body welcoming you to Great Music at St. James and another edition of Classical Sundays at 6, coming to you from St. James in the City on Wilshire Boulevard. Classical Sundays at 6 is presented most Sundays each month live at 6 p.m., October through May. This week we present another pair of trios in a sort of mini-survey of the piano trio universe. We had one by Sergei Rachmaninoff last week. This week it's works by Brahms and Dvořák, two relatively contemporary composers, each of whose music displays distinctive characteristics. We'll begin with the first of the trios by Brahms, his trio in B major, Opus 8. He was just 20 when he composed this work in 1854, and he indeed revised it some 35 years later. We'll conclude the program with the very last of the Dvořák trios, his trio in E minor, the Dumky Trio, Opus 90. An intriguing aspect of the piano trio is the triple solo nature of the format. Each of the three instruments, violin, cello, and piano, can be considered a soloist. In Beethoven's triple concerto, he makes the unusual choice to use three solo instruments, whether singly or in pairs. The interplay between two soloists in the Brahms double concerto for violin and cello, or the Mozart Sinfonia Concertante for violin and viola, just to choose two remarkable examples, is not quite so complex as the music we encounter in these piano trios of Dvořák and Brahms. We'll begin with the revised version of the Brahms Opus 8 piano trio in B major, as we welcome our three artists to the stage to begin this edition of Classical Sundays at 6 with music by Brahms: Neal Stulberg, piano, Tomasz Golka, violin, and Thomas Lohenheim, cello. The trio number 1 in B major, Opus 8, by Brahms.
Thank you.
We've heard the Brahms Trio in B major, Opus 8, in the version revised some 35 years after it was originally composed by the young Brahms, so it's really a mature work. Our program will continue with another unusual work, a particularly unusual work indeed, one of the most distinctive in the repertoire for piano trio. This is music of Antonin Dvořák, and it takes as its form the Ukrainian lament known as the dumka. The plural of that is dumki. There are several movements, indeed, each beginning slowly and then making a quick transition to a faster tempo. This is, as I said, among the most distinctive elements in the repertoire for the piano trio. This is the work that concludes this edition of Classical Sundays at 6. Once again, our trio of soloists is on stage for music by Dvořák, the Dumki Trio.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
We've heard the trio number 4 in E minor, opus 90, of Antonin Dvořák, the Dumki trio, with Neal Stulberg at the piano, Tomasz Golka, the violinist, and Thomas Lohenheim, cellist. Our next event takes place in 2 weeks on April 16th at 6 p.m. when the Formosa Quartet will be here to perform music by Mozart, the string quartet number 15 in D minor, Kerschel 421, and Robert Schumann, the string quartet number 2 in F major, opus 41, number 2. Please visit greatmusicla.org for further news of our 2022-23 season of free concerts and other musical events. Classical Sundays at 6 is made possible in part by a generous grant from the Colburn Foundation in memory of Ed Edelman. Additional support is provided by the generosity of the Friends of Great Music at St. James. To become a friend of Great Music, please visit greatmusicla.org, where all our musical events are offered live and on demand. You're also most welcome to attend our events in person at St. James in the City, located in the Mid-Wilshire District of Los Angeles. This is Dennis Body inviting you to join us next time.